Now notice what took place. Verse 17. And Ananias went his way, entered into the house, and putting his hands on him, said, Brother Saul. What a change. He's still Saul of Tarsus, but he's now Brother Saul. He's not the enemy. Now he's Brother Saul. And any person who knows Jesus Christ is a brother to anyone else. But the brethren don't always act like they're brethren. Now notice, Brother Saul, the Lord, even Jesus, that appeared unto thee in the way as thou camest, hath sent me that thou mightest receive thy sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit. Two things he was to receive now, his physical sight, and also he's to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Now will you notice something that's very important? The filling is something for service. It's the experience. It's that which reveals itself in the life of a believer. He was baptized by the Holy Spirit on the Damascus Road. He was saved on the Damascus Road. But it wasn't until this man came to him that he was filled with the Holy Spirit, because he's going to become a witness for the Lord Jesus. And he receives his physical sight and his spiritual sight. Now notice verse 18 of chapter 9 of Acts. And immediately there fell from his eyes, as it had been scales, and he received sight forthwith, and arose and was baptized. Now, baptized by water. He received the baptism of the Holy Spirit yonder on the Damascus Road. He's now baptized. He was saved on the Damascus Road. He now is baptized by water, which is a sign and seal of his conversion. But the water had nothing to do with his salvation at all. He'd been saved on the Damascus Road. Now notice again, verse 19. And when he had received meat, he was strengthened. Then was Saul certain days with the disciples which were at Damascus. And straightway he preached Christ in the synagogues. Now this man Saul of Tarsus begins immediately to witness. Why? He's filled with the Holy Spirit. And he began to preach Christ in the synagogues, that he is the Son of God. Now, friends, you have to know who he is before you can believe what he did. He died for your sin, and it's because he's the Son of God is the reason he could die for your sins. I couldn't die for your sins, and you couldn't die for mine. I can't die for my own. No other human being can. You've got to know that he's the Son of God. And this is where Paul began. Verse 21, but all that heard him were amazed and said, is not this he that destroyed them which called on the name in Jerusalem and came hither for that intent that he might bring them bound unto the chief priests? But Saul increased the more in strength and confounded the Jews which dwelt at Damascus, proving that this is very Christ, the very Messiah. Now, this man, Saul of Tarsus, also, he's number one in several departments, number one in suffering, number one as a missionary, and I think number one as far as his IQ is concerned. He was a brilliant man. He was able to confound those that attempted to tackle him intellectually.